Welcome everyone to this session about how to integrate OpenTelemetry with APM2 by Dharan Shah. We are glad they can join us today. Without further delay, over to you, Dharan.
Hello everyone. So I'm Dharan. I just a small brief introduction before I get started with this particular talk. I work with BrowserStack and I'm a senior software developer over there. So this basically I'll stop with the introduction. I'll start with the actual work. Actual talk that we have, agenda we have over here. Essentially, Appium is, we all know that Appium has now going to release Appium 2.0, which is going to be a platform in itself rather than just a simple kind of a library. So this particular thing is relating to the 2.0 version of Appium, and hence we have something to offer with the platform that Appium has is offering right now. So this is talk about observability. I wouldn't go into too much of detail of what observability is, but I'll give you a little bit of, I'll give an introduction of each and everything, and then there's a demonstration at the end. So this is the agenda for the talk. Why do we require this, first of all? What essentially is this particular talk? And then the Appium 2.0 introduction to a little bit of how Appium 2.0 works, and why essentially this is where it helped us build this because of the platform itself. And then these other points that we're going to go through one by one. So I'll just start with why particular this talk. So first of all, like Appium 2.0.
Sorry to interrupt, Dharan. I believe there are people who are not able to hear you clearly. You may need to speak up a little. Sorry for
Sure, not a problem. Can you hear me now? I'll be a little bit louder. Just let me know if it's all good in the chat.
Much better, Dharan. Please go ahead.
Okay. Awesome. So essentially, I'll just go through again once again. This essentially the agenda for the talk is the observability part of the any microservices or services that we have in general, and how Appium factors into that. Appium has 2.0 platform right now, which is a new platform kind of for developers, built for developers, and we can modify, build new features around it. So that those all things are what Appium offers, and this is one of the libraries or plugins which we can integrate with Appium and will have an observability feature, which essentially I'm going to talk about what exactly observability is, right? So this is what the talk is about. Moving on, Appium 2.0 essentially introduced the concept of plugins before even going to what observability or what our plugin that we have developed is. The plugin feature essentially that we can extend Appium features that we have already, plus essential new features that we want. Those features are something that not everyone wants, but there are few companies, few folks, few people, individual folks who would want to have that feature. So they can extend their feature set with a plugin, which is what Appium 2.0 as a platform offers. So for the same platform, we have built an OpenTelemetry plugin, which essentially is observability tooling system that we can use to trace down a request from wherever a user's end or wherever it is to the end of our service. And we can trace it down to what exactly, how much amount of time it took, how many requests did we get for a particular endpoint, etc., etc. So all these things are automatically available when you use this plugin, and you'll have all those features available for you to visualize as well. Right. So this is just a brief overview of how the OpenTelemetry plugin is going to look like. And there's a demo at the end. Right. So I'll just show off the basic demo of it. Before that, again, what Appium 2.0 offers is like this is a basic introduction. Essentially, it has a concept of distributed drivers now. You can have an independent decoupled drivers and integrated with them, which is what Appium 2.0 offers. But this talk is more to do with the plugin ecosystem that they're providing, which we can extend APIs. Not every automation use cases obviously require all those kind of commands that everyone uses, right? It's a very broad spectrum. So we can, developers can, or in general, anyone who has some use case for a particular API, for example, can develop their own plugins and integrate with the Appium platform. As you see over here, it's a very basic diagram of how it's going to look like. And you can install it during the runtime and use it as per requirements. It's more to do with a very generic ecosystem that Appium is offering, which we are going to leverage with this particular plugin that we have built. Now to the actual main topic of the talk is what exactly observability is. Like, why would we even require this particular plugin, right? So basically it's to do with right now, as of now, in terms of the increasing large systems and scalability of systems and user bases, we don't have a whole picture of our system and internal state of the system. We do have logs and everything, but there is a limitation over there where it's human readable, but not very easily transferred to a particular way of showcasing how exactly and how much time it took, and essentially giving a very simple way of looking at the metrics of our system, end-to-end system, right? So observability, what it offers, logs is one part of it, yes, but there are multiple things to it. It offers a way of us to identify the internal state of the system at a given point in time. But since there are multiple services, there are distributed services, there could be monolithic as well, it doesn't matter, but there are multiple parts of the monolithic services as well, which we need to identify and what is happening in each particular part of the service. So to do that, we have to transfer some data, some consistent data model. We have to define some consistent data model and then use the data to visualize our systems, right? So essentially, this is what observability is. This give a particular consistent way of looking at the internal state of the system, right? A very common family use cases, set of microservices in large companies who have multiple services. They are talked to it via a messaging protocol or something. But we don't really have a picture of where exactly my request ended or where exactly was an error. To get that picture, we use observability as our way or mechanism to identify what is happening in the system. Right? This is the key pillars of observability. Any questions, obviously, you can ask in the chat. I'll go through this question later on. But this is just an introduction of observability. To get more details about it, obviously, you can check. There are multiple places where you can look for a lot of more information than over here. It's just an introduction of what exactly we are providing. So these are the three pillars essentially of what observability is, like metrics, which number of requests or rate and everything. There is logging information that we obviously do in a distributed system or in general any kind of software that we have. Tracing is one of the key features that it provides us. We can trace a particular request from end to end, where it went, how much time it took in particular one single part of a service, and all those things, it's configurable, all those things you can build, and that's how it's up to us to use how we want to use. It's a very generic tool mechanism that we have. So this particular talk is more towards the tracing part of it, where we are request to Appium, but there could be multiple services before Appium that goes to Appium directly, and then we can trace down what exactly happened, and if there's an error, something that we can track through as well. That's something that we can do via tracing, because essentially that's what Appium is. It's a request response kind of a mechanism. It's a client server model that they provide, which is very similar to obviously what Selenium does offer as well. So this is how our automation works in general. And that's why tracing is going to allow us to identify what exactly happened in Appium, or if it did not even go to the Appium service itself, there is some other services that we have which failed, validation failed or something like that. So that's kind of a mechanism that we provide. And there are multiple use cases over it. I'll go through one demo as well, so we can identify what kind of use cases people have. This is kind of obviously an example of microservice architecture, where there could be multiple microservices and there is a UI and then there's a front end, essentially. There's a back-end database and everything. And there are parts of this where request flows, where in one particular request flows, while there are other requests that doesn't flow to that particular service. So we can identify each particular request. We can trace down, we can filter those as well. So in general, this is a use case. This is a large use case because there is in kind of a system services that people have been offering nowadays, and there are a lot of companies that are offering services for anyone, for business B2B or B2C. There are services that require us to identify in terms of a DevOps or SRE role. We need to identify what exactly happened. And based on, we need data to obviously track down. So this is where we use observability, and we use tracing abilities that we can provide internally via OpenTelemetry, which is one of the standardized tool to build a consistent data model. So I've been talking too much about it. I'll just showcase a demo and everything. If there's any confusion, you'll be able to identify where exactly the question is. So this is a repo, obviously, that we have built. And I'll start with a demo to showcase what exactly we are offering, right? In terms of the plugin itself, which is open source, obviously you can go and check it out yourself as well. So before that, I'll just go through it quickly to the chat and ensure that there is anything that breaks, audio is breaking. Is it okay now? I mean, I haven't done anything, but yeah, it's some form of internet breakage or something like that. Apologies for that. I'll share the slides with the team, and there will be slides available for you to look into, because all the information that I've said about and the audio that I'm not missing or anything, it's already available in the slides, so you can go through it.
It could be a problem, Dharan, with any of the participants also. They are speakers.
Sure. Ensuring
you can focus on it sounds fine right now.
Sure. I'll focus on the demo now. Let's start. So basically, now again, Appium is offering a way to install plugins. This is the plugin that we have developed, which we can use. So essentially, this is what there are readmes in the section, in the open source section of the repo, and then you can check it out how to install and everything. I'll just start with the plugin, and then if any questions later on, I'll update in the readme as well to ensure that everyone understands and how to use it. Obviously, so essentially, this is how I started the plugin. I have started Appium now. Appium is currently working right now, and so if I just curl something, so I get a response back, right? So, but before that, if you see, my curl is to localhost 3000, right? Whereas my Appium started on 4723, which is my Appium default server port, is over here, right? So this is where my proxy comes into play. This is just a very simple proxy to showcase the capability of having microservices and what Appium does, and we use Appium as well. So over here, there is a curl request that's gone through, which essentially is an exporter config and all those things, where all my traces that are being collated, I can export to certain service, one of which is the service is a Jaeger service, which provides a way for us to visualize the data in the traces data. And so essentially right now, everything, all my traces, if you see over here, it's automatically generated. So before that, if I just showcase without a plugin, what would it look like? I've started without the plugin. There is no plugin activated, anything you can see over here. I have available plugins in OpenTelemetry. But if I do curl request or anything, there is no route available for this because my plugin has not been activated, right? But now if I install my plugin and use it, and then there's a added route, which obviously Appium 2.0 has offered for any plugin. They can add your own routes. And now I can do kind of a curl request, and now my exporter configs and all this. This is more of a API thing that I'll add into the readme stuff, part of my repo. But apart from this, for example, if you see over here, I have a curl request which goes to the config, which is a get call, and this is an active exporter config, and all those things are available, which is more to do with how observability works. Let's see how I can visualize this. Obviously, I can see the trace over here, but there's no use to me because it's not very much readable. It's a kind of a common generic JSON data. So there is a API that I've exposed in the plugin, which you can define your own exporters and pass all the configuration related to the exporter. For now, I'm just using a default configuration for Jaeger. So over here, if I do this, I have successfully initialized the Jaeger exporter. Essentially, there is a Jaeger service running in the background that I've started with Docker. And if you see now, there is showing the Jaeger exporter export successfully opened for one particular span, right? So now I have a request, like a curl request, which I do over here. For example, I do a curl config call, right? Or so before that, let's visualize how it works. So if I go over here and see the Jaeger UI, so there is my three services. If you see over here for Appium, which is the Appium service itself, which we have our plugin, right? Over here, it shows me one particular HTTP post call, which is directly directed to the configuration page. But let's say I have Appium under a microservices, right? Multiple microservices. So I can look into this, and for example, I can see there's an Appium proxy, which has a middleware, which is an Express init middleware. Obviously, it's stuff to do with Node.js Express server. Then there is a rate limit, essentially another middleware. Then there is handle proxy, which is another middleware. And then essentially in the end, it goes to HTTP get call, which goes to Appium. Over here, you can see there's some warning. Obviously, you can ignore this for now. For all the information around what the request was, you can see that there is all the request over here. You can trace down to where exactly it went and from where it went to which particular service, where was the endpoint, and essentially all those things. What the endpoint was, how much time it took, which is very important for us to trace down any bottlenecks into our system. All those things are available over here. So for example, let me see if I can like change the rate limitation, and let's based on that I'll showcase how the error part of it would so what the error part of it would give me, right? So I'll open up my notes. Yeah, so I have my plug I have my proxy, right? Proxy running, and for that I'll have to go to this particular repo. Yeah, so sorry about this. So I'll just modify some of our rate limitation stuff so that I can showcase how in the end it basically I can limit kind of. So over here I have max 10 requests. Let me change it to 1 and then restart my proxy. So I have restarted my proxy now and it's running. So now I can make a curl request with a normal get call over here, and yeah, my request is gone through, and I can see it in the Jaeger UI as well, where my request just it's a few seconds. If you see over here, like few seconds ago, this particular request, it went through all the sources. Now let me again request, and I believe so there would be an error for me. So over here, there are too many requests. I'll try again later, right? So this is where tracing would help me identify what exactly happened, right? If I go through the trace page and I see there's another request, if I go and there is another request with an error, right? What's the error? I don't know. But over here, it never went through Appium. This is where we can see that my request never got to the Appium server itself, and it was hauled by some other service that we have, which essentially gives me a non-200 response, I would say, which is essentially what I can see over here and track through. So this is where essentially integrating all the microservices that we have, or even a monolithic with independent parts of the system, we can integrate together and showcase how observability would essentially help us identify bottlenecks in the system, what happened, which like we can filter out over here. This is how Jaeger is a service which provides us to visualize and has its own data store, but there are multiple other exporters as well, and it's available in the plugin as well. If I open up my repo over here, so this is there are multiple exporters available. You can go through it, like over here there are the readme page. If you see, there are multiple exporters available. Obviously Jaeger, we have sure. So we have Prometheus, Jaeger, and Zipkin. So all those things are available. You can go through the page. I'll share all the details on the page with folks over here. And yeah, any questions, anything, obviously there is readme over here, and you can raise issues over here. It's open source. So if any queries you have, anything, we can talk over here as well on the GitHub. So yeah.
Brilliant demonstration, Dharan. That was a great talk. Thanks, Dharan, for sharing your experience with us today.